think it's going to be an exciting evening. I always look forward to comparing the program because it has an air of personal excitement for me. I never know if I'm going to fit into my suit one year from the next, but fortunately we made it again this year. Within the next hour, we'll know which of the ladies you're going to meet will be Miss Peninsula 1984 and Miss Peninsula Charity Queen 1984. Each year, hundreds of girls throughout Queensland join the quest to raise funds for the Spastic Centres of Queensland. There are spastic centres in Maribyrnong, Rockhampton, Toowoomba, on the Gold Coast, Fig Tree Pocket, Rocklea and New Farm. The state headquarters of the Queensland Spastic Welfare League, of course, being New Farm. There is also a spastic centre here in Redcliffe. The young ladies who have been fundraising in this region know how much spastic children and adults need our help, because it takes millions of dollars each year to keep the spastic centres open and working at peak efficiency. It will cost over $8 million during 1983-84 for the Queensland Spastic Welfare League to provide its programs of diagnosis, treatment and training. Although the League receives assistance from both state and federal governments, almost $3 million must be raised through public fundraising activities. Spastic people need and deserve every opportunity the spastic centres can give them. In Queensland alone, there are 3,500 spastic people recorded with the centres, and on an average, 3 new cases are referred each week for assessment by the Queensland Spastic Welfare League's medical team. The ladies who take the spotlight tonight wanted to help their spastic friends reach their goals in life. After tonight, these ladies will strive to reach their own special goals. One of them could become Miss Queensland or even Miss Australia, because the aim of the quest is to promote spastic centres right throughout our country. Of course, it is impossible for every entrant to become Miss Queensland or Miss Australia, although we gave it a very good run last year with our splendid Miss Peninsula, Melinda Goodridge. Each lady is a winner in her own way. She has given priority in her life to the needs of disabled people. I'm sure the entrants have enjoyed the quest, and I'm sure it hasn't always been easy, but they must feel very proud of the results which they have managed to achieve. On behalf of all persons associated with the quest, I'd like to thank people who have contributed in any way to the success that these girls have managed into the quest and to stand before you members of the public this evening. I'm sure you'll recognise this and I'm sure you'll give them your very strict attention and a hearty welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, our first entrant this evening is 18 years old. Please welcome Miss Angela Dux. The National Australia Bank, and in her spare time she enjoys 10-pin bowling, horse riding, swimming and reading. Angela's ambition is to be successful in her career and she hopes to travel also. Hello Angela, how are you tonight? Good, thanks. Angela, I understand that you are interested in travelling. Is there any particular place or places that you'd like to visit?
I would like to travel and see Australia first. With the overseas countries, I'd like to visit Europe, and I think walking down the street to New York would be interesting experience.
Well, John Lennon founded that, didn't he?
Certainly did.
Well, thank you. Hello, Tracy. How are you tonight?
Thank you,
Rachel. Good. Tracy, I understand you're taking dancing lessons at the moment. Can you tell us a little bit about which particular type of dancing you're learning, where you're learning, and that sort of thing?
I'm in the Brisbane Division Dance Group and we do jazz ballet. We train twice a week. It's a lot of fun. We've got plenty of exercise and I like being with all the other girls. And we just do promotional work. It's a lot of fun.
Thanks very much, Tracy. Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Tracy Lunigan. Joanne wants to enjoy life, to travel and to meet new people. Hello Joanne, how are you? Joanne, shooting is a fascinating hobby for a young lady to have. Met anyone lately you'd like to shoot or tell us a little bit about the shooting activities? So just whatever.
I haven't done much of shooting.
Were you in any competitions or was it just a regular social activity to go out and fire a few shots?
More a social activity.
Fine, that sounds very social. No, we don't get parties like that in Redcliffe. Thanks very much, Joanne. So I'm married also. Kerry, I see your ambition is to work in public relations. Which sort of company would you like to work for, and what field specifically in public relations?
Well, hopefully still for James Robert Hairdressers, my sponsor tonight, and in the field of promotions and sales.
Fine, well, we wish you all the best. Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Kerry Johnson for sponsors the ANZ Bank. Tracy has her sights set on becoming a bank manager. Tracy likes meeting people, and in her spare time she plays netball and rides horses. Her sponsors are the Biwa Hotel and Mr. and Mrs. Cornett of Bribey Arrows. Tracy, welcome along tonight. How are you? That's good. Tracy, I understand you've just returned from a trip to America. Can you tell us a little bit about that, please?
Well, yes, Roger. I've been back for about 3 months now.
Fine. Well, thanks very much. Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Tracy Hill. Jenny, how long have you been a member of the Cheerleaders Association? Can you tell us all a little bit about it, please? I didn't even realise we had a Cheerleaders Association as such. Would you like to come in the line? Jenny, I understand you actually have training sessions. Are these very rigorous, and what sort of things do you do to keep fit for them?
Well, I did have a training tonight, 3 months ago, until I started fundraising in Australia.
Put all your energy and perspiration to fundraising. Good. You're pretty involved in cycling now. Do you actually participate in cycling clubs, or have you just freewheeled, so to speak?
No, my cycling is purely for enjoyment. I just like to
run
beach under the shore
with the
beach, up and down
the water, beautiful. Now, I see you're a secretary with the SGIO Building Society. Now, I think it's the Building Society, am I right, or is it the SGIO?
SGIO Building Society.
Now, which branch are you attached to being a secretary with one of the local managers, eh?
Probably more than I stand beside or look at.
Well, it's Roger, isn't it?
Mr. Chairman Upton, you do a marvellous job, and we're very proud of them also. Never know what's going to happen to the open these on the paper. The winner of the Miss Peninsula Charity Queen 1984 title is Jennifer Cowell.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have here our Charity Queen of the Year, Miss Jennifer Cowell. Congratulations, Jennifer. Would you like to say a couple of words?
Well, I'm very honoured, and I must say very surprised to accept this title. And I know from having been selected, what could use the money raised from the quest and from other activities that people will go to. And I'd just like to say thank you. My family and everybody that's
helped me.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, I might at this juncture just invite Miss Melinda Goodrich, the retiring, although she's a little young to retire at this stage, I guess, but the outgoing Miss Peninsula Charity Queen, Miss Peninsula, to say a few words to you all. Please welcome her.
With how this young lady on my right must be feeling, and in consideration of that, I promise to keep this very, very short. Tonight has been a culmination of 12 months of very, very hard work for each of these people and for their family and friends, as I and my mother very, very well know. Tonight, two of these girls will be lucky enough to go on to the Miss Queensland finals. and they will have the pleasure and the honour of representing you, their hard-working background supporters in Queensland finals, in competition with people from all over the state who have all raised money to help cerebral palsy victims. Indeed, it's an unfortunate feature of press at this time that that is usually the image that the public perceives. The real background, the real backbone of the Miss Australia Quest is all of you people here this evening.
It's a pleasure to have here tonight the federal...
Mr. Chairman, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a great afternoon for the committee, and on behalf of the committee, I would like to thank all the beautiful entrants in the who made it easy for us, because when we first arrived there and we were waiting for the first entrant, we were all as nervous as anything, the committee. But they soon made us at ease, and we had a most enjoyable afternoon, and we found something out amongst one of the questions, I believe, anyhow, that really is very, very complimentary to these young ladies and to their families. All of us could read something into what they were saying in their answers, that they really are very mature young ladies, and they answered a few of our questions in that manner. It was a good afternoon, as I said earlier. But it was a hard afternoon, but you have to select a winner. We have selected it, and I'll hand it over now to Mr. White, and he'll be the one to announce.
Well, Mr. Chairman, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, what I'd like to add to the other speakers tonight, my great pleasure to see these wonderful ladies that are with us here tonight. And I think the point that Melinda made is very, very true. It's not just a matter of being in a quest. It's a matter of making a contribution to your fellow man. And in this case, the Miss Australia Quest has made a tremendous contribution over so many years to so many people in our community who are unable to fully look after themselves. I had the great privilege to be the minister responsible for the International Year of the Disabled Person. And during that year, I come to realise and to understand the great challenge in life that it is for so many disabled people. And they all said in their own way, they wanted to all be part of us, part of society. And I think this quest is bringing... Congratulate you for what you've done, Melinda. Beverly Weil and June Upton down there, thank you also for what you've done. He's telling me I've said enough. So I better do the honours. And I know Roger, I'm getting a bit shaky. I don't know whether it was the Dolphins winning today or what it is. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to announce the winner of the Miss Peninsula 1984 title. And the winner is Joanne McCarthy.
Thank you.